This is TWiT.
Ajit Pai this week said that he wanted to have some new transparency obligations. That's what he called it. And John Brodkin from Ars Technica. John Brodkin is the senior IT reporter, and he's going to talk about this story. Welcome to the show, John.
Hey, thanks for having me.
So what did we hear from Ajit Pai? And more importantly, like, why do we think that we heard this particular thing that he decided to say about Google and Facebook and other big wigs?
Well, it's interesting because, you know, as the chair of the Federal Communications Commission, all he's done really is get rid of regulations. And now all of a sudden he's suggesting new regulations for companies that he doesn't regulate. And I mean, he suggested that they should have some sort of transparency rules around their privacy policies and their like free speech policies. And this happens to be the exact same argument that all the companies he regulates have been making, like Comcast, AT&T, and Verizon. They see themselves as competitors to Google and Facebook because they want to get a piece of the advertising market. And so they've been clamoring for more regulations of these companies, and the chair of the Federal Communications Commission just happens to completely agree with them.
And so part of this has to do with Mike Masnick from TechDirt got accidentally emailed some talking points. Can you talk a little bit about what those talking points said and what he learned from them?
Yeah, well, we didn't really learn anything new. It's just sort of funny that they accidentally emailed their internal talking points to a reporter. But anyway, it's kind of the same thing they've been saying, that websites pose a greater threat to the openness of the internet than internet providers do. That's what the internet providers are saying. And so their argument against net neutrality and privacy rules has generally been that websites should have to face just as onerous regulations as the internet providers.
Which it's kind of odd because it seems like a kind of an apple and orange kind of thing, because
right.
the regulations that they have to deal with are completely different than the regulations that the internet, you know, the internet, the platforms versus the infrastructure, I guess. But it's like two different worlds. It's like saying that I don't even have an answer.
Yeah, it's like, I mean, obviously, you know, Comcast and Charter combined, there are like 68 million Americans who their only choice for high speed internet is either Comcast or Charter. So these companies control your entire connection to the internet. They could block or throttle any of these websites entirely. So it's not that there aren't serious issues related to Google and Facebook and Twitter. It's just that it's different. You know, it's the infrastructure versus, you know, the web platforms. Trying to draw like a total parallel between them, it doesn't really work. Like to have the same rules for both.
It's kind of like talking about driving regulations and restaurant regulations. I mean, they don't cross over at all.
Yeah, I mean, different industry. You can't just take, you know, regulations for banking and apply them to any other industry because right. they're industry specific.
Exactly.
And when you're talking about privacy, I mean, the case could be made that you need to use Google, but you don't need to use Facebook and you don't need to use Twitter. But to get online, you need an ISP. And like you said, a lot of people in a lot of places don't have much of a choice.
Right. And there were some basic privacy rules that were put in place by the previous FCC, which required the ISPs to get your consent before they use or share or sell your web browsing histories and for their advertising businesses. And Congress got rid of that. You know, Ajit Pai opposed it, so he supported that decision to get rid of those rules.
And doesn't it, as we move to 5G, and the providers theoretically have a much bigger, a much clearer vision of who you are, this becomes more important, right? Because you're not going to have Comcast at home and T-Mobile at, you know, on your phone. You're just going to have, you know, AT&T or Comcast or T-Mobile, and it's going to be, you're not going to have Wi-Fi routers. You're just going to have five. I mean, that's the theory. That's the dream, right?
I mean, I don't know about that. I don't think 5G is really a surveillance thing.
No, I don't mean a surveillance thing. I mean that's you're not splitting up your service as much. You know, right now I don't think of my home service as the same as my cell service. I mean, I guess people who use AT&T do, but I mean, I don't have the same things, and so they have a vision of me in one place and a vision of where I go and the IP, you know, what I.
Yeah, well, I think in like rural areas where they don't want to build out fiber, AT&T and Verizon are talking about 5G home broadband. If you already have a fiber connection at home or cable, I think you'll still end up with a separate home internet and wireless.
So you're not arguing that it doesn't make sense for Congress to look into Facebook or Twitter or Google, right?
No, I said in my story, you know, there are good reasons for Congress to look at it. I'm not proposing any particular rules. And Pai's proposal, it was very vague. He just said there should be new transparency rules. So I was just observing that, you know, he's basically adopting the exact lobbying points of the industry that he regulates while they're trying to compete against these other companies and, you know, ask Congress for new regulations. So he's taken the broadband lobby's argument. He's just taking it and advanced it, you know, under his own name.